Hello friends, I hope you like my videos, and if you are having any question you can ask me in the comment. So in this video we will discuss about the EU Annex 11 guideline. Right. So the guideline name is Annex Volume 4 and title is Good Manufacturing Practice Medicinal Products for Human and Veterinary Use, and Annex 11 is applicable for the computerized system. So friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please view, like, comment and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So first we will discuss what is EU Annex 11. So EU Annex 11 is a regulatory guideline issued by the European Commission as part of the Good Manufacturing Practice Regulations. Right? So this guideline is applicable for European country. So when you are working for European country, then you have to follow this guideline, right? It specifically addresses the computerized system used in pharmaceutical manufacturing, ensuring their compliance with GMP standard. So Annex 11 talks about the what should you consider for compliance when you are working with the computerized system, right? Next, Annex 11 provides guidance on the use of electronic records and electronic signature in the pharmaceutical production environment, right? As you know, 21 CFR Part 11 talks about the electronic record and electronic signature requirement for US. In the same way, this guideline talks about the electronic record and electronic signature requirement for European country, right? Now in this slide, we will discuss the objectives of Annex 11, right? So first, it ensures integrity, reliability and confidentiality of electronic records and data. That is, electronic records should be safe and reliable, right? Next is facilitate the compliance with regulatory requirement. So fulfilling the requirement of Annex 11 will comply the regulatory requirement, right? Next is it enhances data security and data management practices. So following Annex 11 guideline will enhance the data security, right? Next, promote the adoption of technology while maintaining regulatory compliance. So it will enhance to adopt the new automated technology. So now in this slide, we will discuss the key requirements of EU Annex 11. So first one is the validation. So computerized system must be validated to ensure they are consistently produce accurate and reliable result. So validation must be performed prior to use of the system, and also the periodic evaluation must be done, right? Next is data integrity. So electronic records must be complete, consistent and accurate throughout their life cycle. So integrity of data generated by using computerized systems should be maintained, right? Next is security control. So the adequate security measures must be implemented to protect electronic records from unauthorized access, data alteration or data deletion, right? So appropriate IT control must be there to protect the unauthorized access, which may include the login credential or biometric access, etc., right? Next is audit trail. So system should maintain an audit trail that documents all critical events and actions, allowing for traceability and accountability, right? So audit trail should appropriately record each and every activity which is performed in that computerized system, right? Next is electronic signature. So electronic signature must be secure, unique to the individual and linked to the respective electronic records only, right? So electronic signature will ensure the identity of the individual, and when that individual is going to, you know, perform that electronic signature, either maybe he is submitting, he or she is submitting that documents, so that particular document will only capture that electronic records, right? Next is documentation. So comprehensive documentation including policies, procedure and user manuals should be maintained for all computerized systems. So all the documentation related to that particular system should be maintained all the time, right? Now here we will discuss about the principle of EU Annex 11. So this principle is exactly mentioned in the EU Annex 11 guideline, right? So as we already discussed this, as this guideline will be applicable for computerized system, and whatever the system we are using, that should be validated. And when you are using the computerized system in place of manual operations, so there should not be any compromise with respect to the product quality, process control or quality assurance. And also there should not be increase in the risk with respect to the product quality and process. So such things are explained into this principle guideline, right? So now we will discuss the major section in the guideline. So basically they have divided into three major sections for this guideline. So first one is the general. So in the general guideline, you can say they talked about the risk management, personnel, supplier and service providers. Next section is project phase. So they talked about the validation, that is how you are going to validate your system and what should be the criteria for it. And next section is operational phase. So in the operational phase, when you have validated that system, so what should be the expectation? So it is it talks about the data accuracy checks, data storage, printouts, audit trials, change and configuration management, periodic evaluation, security incident management, electronic signature, batch release, business continuity and archiving plan. So such kind of things they have explained into these three major section, right? So we will discuss into the detail. So first we will discuss about the general section, right? So first one is the risk management. So risk management should be applied throughout the life cycle of the computerized system, taking into account for the patient safety, data integrity and product quality, right? So the risk assessment should be performed at initial phase of the validation to assess the severity of risk with respect to the patient safety and product quality, right? Next is personnel. So there should be close cooperation between all relevant personnel, that may be your process owners and system owner, qualified person and IT department also. So all persons should have appropriate qualification, level of access and defined responsibility to execute their activity. So who are involved into the validation project, that should be well qualified and educated and having the defined responsibility to complete the validation activities, right? So next is supplier and service provider. So when any third parties are involved, like any vendor or suppliers that are used to install, configure, integrate, validate and maintain or modify or retain a computerized system or any related activities, it may be your data processing also, so formal agreement must be exist between the manufacturer and third party, right? It may be the vendor side on-site activity, or maybe they will provide the support remotely, right? So these agreements should include the clear statement of the responsibilities of the third party. So the competence and reliability of a supplier are key factor when selecting a product or service provider. So the need for an audit should be based on the risk assessment, right? So your vendor will be the key factor while having any automated system, and vendor audit should also be performed to check the vendor capabilities to deliver the quality products and services, right? Documentation supplied with commercial of the self product should be reviewed by the regulated users to check that user requirements are fulfilled. So any documents which are provided by the vendor for COTS product, that should be thoroughly reviewed by the responsible person to check out the documents it's meeting the user requirement or not, right? So quality system and audit information related to supplier or developers of software and implemented systems should be made available to inspector on request. So all validation documents should be readily available for the audit purpose, right? So now we will discuss about the project phase section. So project phase section basically discuss about the validation, right? So the validation documentation and report should cover the relevant step of the life cycle. So validation plan should be prepared to address how the protocol should be prepared and what should be the acceptance criteria. Validation documentation should include change control and deviation observed. So as the part of GMP practice, first you have to initiate the change control. So record should be maintained for this. And also if any deviation observed while system validation, that should also be addressed and resolved properly, right? An up-to-date listing of all relevant system and their GMP functionality should be available. So user department should have the one inventory where the details of system is mentioned with the system functionality, right? For critical system, an up-to-date system description detailing the physical and logical arrangements, data flows and interfaces with other system, that should be defined. So this can be elaborated into the validation documents, or maybe you are having a separate procedure to elaborate the these things, right? User requirement specifications should describe the required functions of the computerized system and be based on the documented risk assessment and GMP impact. So URS should cover all the end user requirement, right? System developed in accordance with an appropriate quality management system. So quality management system should be followed while validating the system, right? The suppliers should be assessed properly. So supplier assessment should be done appropriately, right? For the validation of bespoke or customized computerized system, there should be a process in place that ensure that formal assessment and reporting of quality and performance measures of all the life cycle stages of the system. So for the customized computerized system, process should be established to validate the system and ensure that the system performance are satisfactory throughout the life cycle, right? Evidence of the appropriate test method and test scenarios should be demonstrated, right? So evidence for all the executed tests during the validation should be maintained and documented. If data transferred to another data format or system, validation should include the check that data are not altered. So during the any migration related activity, so migration of data from old system to new system, we should be careful about that. Data integrity should not be, violated. That data integrity should be ensured, right? So now we will discuss the next section, that is operational phase. So it talks about the data. So computerized system exchanging data electronically with other systems should include appropriate built-in checks for the correct and secure entry and processing of data in order to minimize the risk. For example, if single software system connected with multiple hardware, then data should be correctly exchanged from the particular system. That should be ensured during the validation activities, right? Next is accuracy checks. So for critical data entered manually, there should be an additional check on accuracy of the data, right? So the entire data should be checked by the reviewer to ensure the accuracy of the data. Next is data storage. So data should be secured by the both physical and electronic means against the damage. And regular backups of all relevant data should be performed, and restoration of data should also be done periodically. So for example, generated data should be backed up for security of data, for the purpose of security of data on daily basis. And also the restoration process should be performed to check the integrity of backup data, right? Next is printouts. So it should be possible to obtain clear printed copies of electronically stored data. And for record supporting batch release, it should be possible to generate printouts indicating if any of the data has been changed since the original entry. So print of the electronically generated data can be taken to support the batch release, right? Yeah. Now the next is audit trails. So audit trails should record of all GMP relevant changes and deletions. For change or deletion of GMP relevant data, the reason should be documented, right? Audit trails need to be available and should be convertible. So the audit trail feature should be available with the system, and it should be record all the activity which has been executed into the system, right? Next is change and configuration management. So any changes to a computerized system, including system configuration, should only be made in a controlled manner in accordance with the defined procedure, right? So if any changes are required to be done, then change control process should be followed. Next is periodic evaluation. So computerized systems should be periodically evaluated to confirm that they remain in a validated state and are compliant with the GMP, right? So periodic evaluation should also be performed, and it may include the current range of functionality, deviation records, incident, upgrade, any upgrade history, the system performance and reliability and security of data. Next is security. So system to protect from unauthorized access. So there should be a login credential or biometric or any other access and login mechanism should be established to avoid the unauthorized access into the system, right? So creation, change and cancellation of access authorization should be recorded. So there should be a procedure and tracking mechanism to record these activities. So management system for data and for document should be designed to record the identity of operators entering, changing, confirming or deleting data, including date and time. So these things can be tracked through the audit trail feature, right? Next is incident management. So all incident, not only system failures and data errors, should be reported and assessed. So the root cause for a critical incident should be identified and should form the basis of corrective and preventive action. So the procedure for handling of incident should be established to record and investigate the object incident in that particular system, right? So now the next is electronic signature. So electronic records may be signed electronically, and electronic signature are expected to have the same impact as handwritten signature within the boundaries of the company, and also expected to be permanently linked to their respective record, that is original record. And also it is expected to include the time and date that they were applied, right? So electronic signature will be considered as the equivalent of the handwritten signature, and when electronic signature will be applied, then identity of the person can be tracked and also date and time can be tracked, right? Next is batch release. So when a computerized system is used for recording certification up and batch release, the system should allow only qualified person to certify the release of batches. So batch release should be done by the qualified personnel only by means of electronic signature, right? Next is business continuity plan. So in the event of a system breakdown, an alternative process should be established. So if the system is under breakdown, so alternative approach should be there to release the product. So it may be include your manual process or any other alternative system, right? Next is archiving data may be archived. So this data should be checked for accessibility, readability and integrity. If any changes are made to the system, then data retrievals should be performed and tested to ensure the integrity of the data, right? So friends, this is all about the EU Annex 11. Thank you.